Thanks, Kirilluk. Minister, insofar as this bill seeks to address two central areas, the fact that the REAs were struck down as a result of a court ruling and need to be replaced, that is obviously welcome. And similarly, insofar as it seeks to address the whole issue of collective bargaining, that is something that is long overdue in terms of addressing it. Obviously, the context for this is a pretty dire situation, I would say, where we have the second highest level of low pay in the OECD, where 16% of those who are living in poverty are working, the phenomena of the working poor, where we have, and I think this government has been really central in pursuing this agenda of bringing in the so-called labour activation schemes, such as JobsBridge and Gateway, which, to my mind, and I think to the mind of many people out there, are exploitative schemes that are essentially employing cheap labour instead of employing people on a properly paid basis to do real jobs that need to be done, whether it's by local authorities or allowing in the private sector, in the case of JobBridge schemes, essentially employers to have free labour. So that certainly, I would say, and I think many would say, these sort of schemes have been a mechanism to massage the unemployment figures and essentially encourage a push to the bottom in terms of wages and conditions, and to sort of further really the low pay economy. And another important dimension to the situation in which, in the context in which we're debating this legislation, is, has already been referred to, the whole situation around bogus, what's known as bogus self-contract, contracting, the RTC system, the abuse of it, which was particularly highlighted around the Rattigan's dispute. But in fact, certainly what construction workers will tell you is absolutely endemic across the construction sector, with absolutely flagrant, widespread, massive abuse of that system by developers, by big contractors who are using it as a mechanism to really exploit workers in the most appalling way. And the Rattigan situation, where workers were effectively getting €5 an hour, discovered after 6 weeks and then forced out to go on strike, of getting €5 an hour, was really just appalling. And of course, it's worth remembering that they were fully vindicated when they finally went to the courts, that the abuses they claimed were happening, that they were being exploited, that this system was being abused. And talking to those workers and others concerned in this area ever since, I mean, really, it's an area where urgent action is needed by this government to address this whole scheme, where there seems to be no serious effort by Revenue to address it. One allegation made by workers concerned in this area is that there's a massive loss to Revenue, that when you look at the number of people who are employed under the RTC system, the numbers are absolutely massive and disproportionate. I mean, of course, there are real subcontractors out there, but many of them, if you look at them carefully, don't fit any serious criteria of being a subcontractor. The tenders they put in, often for public jobs, are a joke. If there was any serious examination of them, it would show that they are completely, that they are putting in tenders that are just can't be done. They couldn't be done unless they were brutally exploiting the people who were working for them. Laughable addresses for these subcontractors. One I'm looking at here, which was in relation to St. Patrick's College, the college development, a public contract, where the contractor was turned out to be an undertaker's on the Lisburn Road. Was supposedly the address. It was the address of the contractor who was employing the people to do the job on St. Patrick's College and drug contract. There's too much to go into there, but this is a very serious abuse. So these things have to be looked into. Now, on the bill itself, obviously the REA being re-established is a positive development. We're going to have to look at the details in committee. Stage just to make sure it's fully robust. The whole issue of whether a group is substantially representative, I think, is the key issue we need to look at, and to ensure that, that workers, that there's not too many hoops for people to jump through in order for them to be able to avail of these employment agreements to ensure decent conditions at a sectoral level or in the registered employment agreements. But just the last point I just want to make is on the whole issue of collective bargaining. And what I would say, again, we haven't got time now, and we can discuss it at committee, we need to scrutinise the claim by the government that we can't, for constitutional or legal reasons, establish, union recognition where the employer is obliged to recognise a trade union. The government will no doubt argue we can't do that, and therefore this is the best way to get around it. However, I think there is still a substantial difference between proper trade union recognition and an employer being required to recognise a trade union, which should be a basic right for workers, and what has been proposed in this legislation, which is potentially also open to abuse by the employers.